6-1.
I think he will. I think he'll be one of three or four guys who gets that assignment tonight. They'll keep moving people around and get Barno in on him and Gill on him. We'll take a look and see how they open up.
Kenny Battle jumping for Illinois. The tip batted into the air, finally into the backcourt. Taken away there by Sims. And he gives it to Chris Jackson. Off on the side, that's Tracy.
Gill is on Jackson starting out. There's the first shot. That's what he does so well. He doesn't dribble it much. He just comes up shooting.
Kendall Gill with it. Out front, Liberty. Backdoor, Anderson. Good pass from Liberty.
Nice move by Anderson to get free down the backside. We're tied up at two.
Blanton drives into the lane. Well, the two guys we talked about, Jackson and Blanton, have scored for the first time here tonight for LSU. They lead it 4-2.
He went right through the Illini defense that time, just like nobody was there.
Cole Hamilton gets it underneath. It's deflected out of bounds by LSU. It'll go back over to Illinois.
Perhaps you can get a taste of this crowd. Boy, they're really excited about this ball game. LSU has lost, Dick, already twice here in this building, but they've come to play in this one, at least in the early going, and it would be nothing but a feather in their cap with their young team if they could knock off the number five team in the country.
Kendall Gill will toss it in for Illinois. In close to Nick Anderson. Right back to Gill. Loses it, picked up by Hamilton, and he puts it in.
Gill thought he was fouled, and perhaps he was, but it wasn't called, and Hamilton got it.
Pressure put on. That's Sims with it. Gets it back to Tracy. It was a walk-on basketball player, Dennis Tracy, out of New Orleans, and this is the man of the hour, Chris Jackson. Flips off on the side to Blanton, down under to Sims.
Sims is a big boy. He's 6'7 and 245 pounds. He started quite a bit last year as a freshman.
Kendall Gill. Back door to Battle. Misses it. Picked up off the floor by Anderson, and he's got it in.
I'll tell you, we mentioned LSU averaging 105 points a game. Illinois is averaging 96, so we may not be able to keep up with this one.
But on the other side, the Illini have yielded only a 73-point-per-game average, whereas LSU 91. This is Jackson against Gill. Anderson on the boards.
That was Jackson's first three-point try.
A firing pass intended for Marcus Liberty, too hot to handle. And it goes out of bounds to the Tigers, all tied at six. Lou Henson right there.
Well, I try to get the running game going, but you've got to have the numbers. Now LSU comes back. Jackson, as we've got another clock problem. We've got another clock problem. It showed 7:45. It should be, I would guess, 17:45. The official score, well, they all say 17 now, but a moment ago they said 7:45. They put the extra one up there, and the official's talking things over with the official scores table.
It's apparently in order, and we'll reset the play, and Illinois will have the basketball out of bounds at midcourt.
Looked like a wrestling match there for a minute. They throw that rolled up towel out on the floor.
Boy, this would be something to sit around and think we're going to play a basketball game of this magnitude without a clock, wouldn't it? Is there an electrician in the house, right? Here comes Kendall Gill.
Here goes again, back to 7:42 now. They're losing the...
Dale Brown is really upset about this. There's Lou. It's going to be a confusion. There's no question about it. What do you do when you don't have a clock that works?
Now they're going to meet with both coaches there at midcourt.
I wonder if the clock over on the side, down low underneath above the tunnel as you go out, works. Maybe they can just handle that one and forget about the one high above.
No, I think we're all tied in together because as I looked when it went out the last time, both of those clocks were out. The score, by the way, if you're just tuning in, is LSU 8, Illinois 6. We just played about 2 minutes and 15 seconds of this ball game, and the clock started giving us problems. Here we go now.
LSU setting up into a 2-3 zone right now. Under to Hamilton, drives down through the lane, and he's got it. It's all tied at 8.
Hamilton's got 4 points.
Blanton. Shot up. No. Rebounded away by Hamilton.
Anderson got good defense on Blanton that time. Made him force the shot a little bit before he wanted to.
Kendall Gill. They're working against the zone. Here's Liberty. Cole Hamilton makes a move.
Good move. Hamilton's off to another good start. He's got 6. Averaging 15 a game.
Down and across on the far side to Pajeski. The ball deflected away out of bounds by Kenny Battle. And that's what we were talking about at the start of the broadcast. The enthusiasm and the intensity of Kenny Battle just rubs off on the other four. Bardo is going to come into the lineup now for Illinois.
Number 35.
Replaces Marcus Liberty, who will sit down. Illinois leading it 10-8. Blanton inbounds it to the big guy out of Denmark, and he loses it out of bounds. Gert Hamming comes in. He is a 6'11 freshman from Dieren, the Netherlands.
Lou Hinton talking it over with Steve Bardo, who will put the ball in play. Now Nick Anderson steps out to throw it in. If you get a good look at Blanton sometime this evening, you notice he got a black eye. He had a broken nose from a practice session, so he's kind of rugged looking tonight, but a good ball player.
Bardo now at the point guard. Kendall Gill off on the wing. Gill has got the jump shot. Rebound Sims of LSU up to Jackson. Gill working on Jackson, and he fires it up and out. Rebound Hamilton.
Jackson, 2 nights ago in the Tennessee Martin game, scored only 21, but he had a case of the flu.
Jump ball out of bounds, Illinois. Good defense by LSU. Lowell Hamilton was trying to fake for the little jump shot. The fans seek, of course, he traveled with it, but it was deflected away as he came down. He caught it, and it's the right call. Shot Anderson, no good.
Here's a look at the jump ball call. As he comes back down, but he did have the hand on the ball, Blanton did, so they called it a jump ball. In the meantime, the ball goes out of bounds under the LSU basket where the Tigers will have it.
Well, there's a break in the action from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. And we're going to return after this on the Illini Sports Network. Welcome back to Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Dick Martin along with Steve Kelly. There's the score. Having problems still with the clock. It shows 16-10 to go in the half. They get it out in front. This is Chris Jackson into the lane.
Tough shot. That was a lean-in jumper, and he got it away. He's got 6 now. It's tied again at 10.
Bardo moving it down for Illinois. That's Wayne Sims pulling way out in front to pick up Bardo. And Hamilton, he's going against the 6'11 freshman underneath, and boy, Nick Anderson forces it up, and he's got it.
Anderson's off to a much better start offensively tonight than he was in the Missouri game. He scored only 8 points in that whole ball game. He's got 6 now.
Tracy with it, gets it right back to Jackson. That's the guy they want to have the basketball.
Kendall Gill has the tough job right now.
Blanton shooting it up from outside, and a foul on Bardo.
Really much of a threat from the three-point range, and although he tried one there, he's not the greatest of outside shooters, shooting only 29% from long range. But he's a strong inside player, averaging 26 a game with a career high of 37. There's his black eyes and his broken nose.
Well, I know how he feels. Blanton got that one in. We've got a tie ball game. Bardo.
Dale Brown thought he threw an elbow, but no call.
Comes outside to Gill.
Needs some help.
Bardo. Here's Kenny Battle.
They're doing a good job on Battle so far. He hadn't touched the ball much. Bardo on the drive.
Great reverse by Battle. Patience shown by the Illinois offense right there. They lead at 14-12. Tracy to Blanton. Gets it off to Jackson. Boy, he has the shot blocked away, but a foul on Nick Anderson. And Lou Henson a little bit upset with Kendall Gill the way he's playing defense on Jackson. He's going to spell him, I'm sure, because Larry Smith is going to check into the Illinois lineup right here.
Jackson is so quick. He's got the real quick first step. He has real quick hands. He goes between his legs quite a bit, and he didn't really dribble the ball a whole lot. He'll bounce it a couple of times and put it up.
He's attempted on the year 49 free throws, and there you see his percentage. That's way more than anyone on the LSU team. He rattles the rim and makes it, making his seventh point of the night.
A lot of fans will remember the name of Laterial Green, who was a highly sought-after guard last year that went to Georgia and is playing well. Well, Green and Jackson played about 30 miles apart in Mississippi. Those were the top 2 point guards in the country last year.
Smith to Lowell Hamilton.
Hamilton's got 8 points.
This is Blanton with the ball. Picked up by Bardo out in front. Side Tracy underneath the Sims. Boy, and Bardo did a good job on the board for Illinois right there. Nick Anderson, 3-point shot. The ball slapped over into the corner, and Jackson retreats for the Tigers. Down court off of the hands of Blanton, out of bounds to Illinois.
That was a nice play by Steve Bardo. He got a hand in to knock the ball off of Blanton's body and out of bounds. Illinois will come back with it, leading by a bucket.
Smith with the basketball, and again that zone set up by the Tigers. Bardo with it, now to Anderson, underneath Lowell Hamilton.
He's hot.
Hamilton has 10 points. He can score a whole lot inside tonight.
They're having trouble with their, they've got some guys that are bigger than Lowell, but they don't have the jumpers to stay with him.
Blanton with it. Boy, a good strong move by Blanton. There's a fine move, and Battle gets loose. He is hammered away. He'll go to the line with two. The foul is on Blanton, his first, the first on the Tiger.
Well, that was strictly to save a basket. It was not a flagrant foul. It was a good smart foul.
Well, this is just real great basketball move right here by Blanton, Steve.
He takes it right down the lane and changes the shot a couple of times, which you've got to do, and he dropped it in. He came down and committed the foul on the other end. Ken Battle on the line. There's Battle with a breakaway. He was going to slam it, and Blanton came through and made sure that he did.
Kenny Battle makes it 19-16 Illinois. Timeout is going to be taken. They have a tradition here at LSU. When they announce the starting lineups of the opposing team, they start throwing big paper wads out on the floor. We were told that would happen, and I tell you, we were bombarded, Steve Kelly.
What they do is when they're introducing the Illinois players or the opposing players, they read the newspapers, and they wad them up and throw them at you.
Illinois by four. It's Chris Jackson. Looks around Smith. Great feed underneath. Sims can't get it. Bardo steals it. Down court. This is Larry Smith. He loses the ball. Picked up by Jackson. The big guy is faked out by Jackson's pass, and it goes out of bounds to Illinois.
Well, Jackson was a little too quick that time, as he probably should have put the shot up.
Burnell Singleton out of South Natchez, Mississippi, comes in now for the...
Ragged out there as Larry Smith had maybe a 2-on-2 or maybe 3-on-2 break, but he couldn't control it. LSU was putting the ball in play under its own basket.
Well, just a moment ago, a foul is going to be whistled on Bardo. And that's 2-on, Steve. And Lou Henson a little bit upset with the call. And he is voicing his displeasure right there.
Well, we have a chance to mention the officials. As we said at the beginning, of these officials are from the Southeastern Conference. Normally you work with a split crew, but the agreement that Coach Henson and Coach Brown have is that when LSU comes to Champaign next year, or whenever the return trip is, it'll be all three Big Ten officials.
Chris Jackson now with 10 points, and Illinois' lead is 2. Bardo working it against Tracy. Foul is on Tracy.
Tracy reaching about around the back of Steve Bardo as he went by.
The second team foul on the Tigers. It's out of bounds to Illinois over on the far side. Nick Anderson will toss it in.
Kendall Gill sent the check back in for Illinois. Bardo will come out with 2 fouls.
So Smith and Gill will be in the backcourt. That front line made up of Anderson, Hamilton, and Battle. Larry Smith assuming the point. still into his zone. On the side, Anderson. Comes back outside with it to Smith. Now Nick makes a move. Look at that drive to the basket. No. And a technical foul is going to be called on Illinois. Apparently it's on Lowell Hamilton for holding onto the rim, Steve Kelly.
I saw the hands up there. I thought that really for a moment there was an LSU player on the rim. Lewis not real happy with that. We'll take a look and see if we can see it. I thought LSU was guilty of basket interference right there. And nope, it was Hamilton. It sure was Hamilton up on the rim. That's a technical foul. Layton will shoot the technical.
That makes it 20-19. The ball out of bounds to the Tigers in midcourt.
Marcus
into the lineup. And he's going to replace Lowell Hamilton now. Blanton will toss in to Sims, back to Blanton.
Battle is on Blanton.
This is Tracy against Gill. To Singleton, now outside Jackson.
Larry Smith out on Jackson now. Now Gill switches to him.
Blanton to Sims, back in front to Tracy. Backdoor pass is batted around, but luckily enough, Blanton was there to get it. Way across court, Tracy with a long one.
The walk-on with a three-pointer, and LSU leads 22-20. It's getting noisy in the death zone.
Marcus Liberty.
Back pass.
Battle doesn't get it in, but the foul on LSU.
Not a good pass on Marcus Liberty's behalf there. They hit the board. Luckily, Battle was able to come up with it and got the shot off and was fouled.
Singleton picking up the foul. That's his first, but this is the third on LSU here in the half. Still have 11:53 to play.
Battle will have a fair.
Kenny Battle is 2-for-2 thus far at the line. There you see his points per game average. Great game he had against the Missouri Tigers on Monday night, scoring 28.
He was 1 point shy of a career high in that ball game. His career high coming last year in the finals of the Illini Invitational against Auburn.
Rebound by Sims. This is Jackson. And Gill there with him.
Boy, he's quick.
Sims shot. No. Check it yourself.
The ball definitely was not going in the basket. Well, maybe it was. It's hard to tell from that angle, but it was a goaltending call nonetheless.
We'll return to Baton Rouge after these words from your local stations. T called on himself. He's not too happy with what's happened so far officiating-wise. Here's Nick Anderson breaking down quickly. That's what happened in the field goal department. Liberty back on the side. Gill outside to Smith.
Coach Henson may not have to try too much harder to get a tee.
Boy, Kendall Gill makes a good move to the basket on a fine pass from Larry Smith. Jackson up to Sims, back to Blanton. Off now to Singleton.
Nice fast break. They had no trouble whatsoever with the Underroy press right at that time.
Singleton stealing the pass intended for Liberty. On LSU, apparently.
I think he may have stepped out of bounds after he made the play.
Oh, he traveled, right? See, there he is out of bounds.
Put on the line.
Nick Anderson, Larry Smith, to Battle.
Nice pass to Larry Smith. We need to get Battle a little more into the offensive flow.
Tracy brings it over on the far side. Scoops underneath Sims, right to hook a pass, and Nick Anderson steals it for Illinois. Fires to Gill.
Got it. Illinois regains the lead at 27-26 at the 10-minute mark.
Marcus Liberty almost with a steal.
Now Dale Brown's trying to get a technical. He's
a foul.
That is for him. Into Sims, now right back to Tracy. Kendall Gill really trying to deny Jackson the basketball.
You've got to. He's so quick he can get by you with the ball.
Blanton scoops inside. Sims right back to Singleton.
Good ball movement by the Tigers. As they go, the Illini are going to be looking to Blanton and Jackson. On top by one at 29-28.
Across the top of the defense to Blanton. Great rebound by Singleton.
Now they got to get on the boards.
Locked away by Liberty out of bounds. Boy, that was a real reject. Major league real reject right there by Liberty. It's out of bounds to LSU over in the corner. Tracy goes out of the lineup. And for LSU, Lyle Moulton, a 6'4 sophomore from Lafayette, Louisiana, in to replace him. It comes in to Moulton down in the corner. Outside, Blanton. Give and go underneath. Sims.
Play out of the Illinois playbook on that one.
Larry Smith.
He needs some help. There, I know that Coach Henson would have rather he laid that ball in rather than try for the stuff. He got the foul, but he did not get the basket. He had the easy layup. Kendall Gill will go to the line where he's a 75% foul shooter.
In for LSU is Kurt Hammack, and sitting down is going to be Wayne Sims. Kendall Gill at the line with two for Illinois. Kendall will get one more. He can tie it up at 32 with this one. 8:31 to go in the half. This is both of them. Rebound by Battle. Outside to Smith. Liberty to Lowell Hamilton.
Good defensive job by Blanton that time. Liberty for three. Got it.
3-point shot by Liberty. Illinois with the pressure on. Moulton. Here's a steal. You can see it coming. Kendall Gill.
Nice move by Gill.
To the big guy, Hammack.
There's the lead. Get the rebound.
Hamilton. Up to Gill. To Larry Smith. Boy, Hamilton down the middle. Just what up.
Oh, what is it?
Oh, Battle almost had one, but Liberty picked up the foul.
I'm not sure where Battle came from on that one. Out of nowhere. He was up above everybody with a two-hand tip. It wouldn't fall. Come down on the break as we go to break. Battle will try to tip it in. He gets up but can't get it to go down.
Well, almost a sensational tip in by Kenny Battle. Well, with exactly 7.5 minutes remaining here in Baton Rouge in the first half, Illinois leads by 4, and we'll return after this on the Illini Sports Network. Well, welcome. Welcome back to Baton Rouge. And a moment ago, the intensity of the Illinois defense picking up. There's Kendall Gill with a steal. He's been famous for that since he's been in Illinois. He went the distance and put it in. So, 7.5 minutes to go here, and Illinois leading 36-32. And the Tigers will inbound it. They slap it away and out of bounds. It'll go to LSU.
I think the defense is certainly picking up for the Illini. It will be more of a factor. LSU has handled the press pretty well a couple of times, but the last couple of times down the floor, they have not.
Well, they get it into the hands of the guy they want to have it, and that is Chris Jackson. He's going against Kendall Gill as they move it across.
Hard to stop that. He just comes up, dribbles about five times, and puts up a jump shot, and he doesn't need a whole lot of room to get the shot off.
What a tremendous quick release by Chris Jackson. Loses the pass from Smith. Going across to Gill. Underneath Hamilton. Loses the ball out of bounds, but it was touched away underneath by Sims of LSU, and it'll go back to Illinois.
You know, they've had that chance a couple of times, Dick, but the pass has not been real good. Larry Smith not getting a good pass to ask Battle Brook in the basket that time. It kind of threw it behind him, which altered Kennedy's plans with the basketball. They got lucky and got the ball out of bounds.
Here is Gill from across the way, and he makes it. That's 8 points of the game for Gill. They get it up to Blanton. Three on two to Sims. Partially batted away, but Liberty does the job. Boy, what a great outlet pass to Battle by Liberty. Battle gets it to Liberty, and he kicks it out of bounds. It's going to go back to LSU.
Battle just couldn't hang on to it that time. Battle was trying to get control of it. Liberty came by and booted it out of the way. So LSU would get it back, trailing the Illini by four. There's a steal by Liberty.
They thought he was going to travel, but he didn't travel.
That was a bad call.
He didn't travel. You look at it at home, folks.
The only thing here is if the ball hit the rim. The ball did hit the rim, and he came back down with it, but I don't think that would have an effect on it either. They called traveling Lou and everybody on the Illinois bench is there. They're giving the ball to LSU. We'll try to get a determination on the ruling, but the ball hit the rim, but he came back down with it. I don't know if they called that a shot or what they called it. We'll try to find out.
Yeah, here's Chris Jackson with it for LSU. 38-34, Illinois leading it. 6:15 to go in the half. Jackson off the planted now. Underneath. Drive single. He's got six. Is Larry Smith. Under the Battle. Oh, what a great pass inside, and Hamilton slams it. Hamilton with his seventh basket and a half. They're going to be in trouble here. Chris Jackson. Oh, a foul on Lowell Hamilton.
Jackson was shaken up. He took quite a hit into Hamilton at the official scorer's table. And he's still down. There's a look at it. Jackson and Hamilton both going for the ball. They first hit each other, and they both hit the table, but Jackson hits it much harder. He's up and okay, though, but quite a spill into the official scorer's table.
Irvin Small comes into the lineup for Illinois, replacing Marcus Liberty.
On that last play down there, we know they did call traveling on that play. What we don't know is exactly why. At any rate, Illinois still leads it by four.
Jackson off to Blanton. Flips over on the side to Tracy. Now to Blanton. Underneath it goes, and a steal taken away by Irvin Small. He stepped right in front of Singleton and stole the pass. Here's Irvin. Underneath the Battle. Back outside to Smith. Hamilton can't hang on to it. It goes out of bounds.
The ruling on that last play, not to keep going back to it, but he went up and down with it, but the point was he caught the ball in the air. He was not on the ground to begin with.
Well, there's a break in the action here at LSU, and we're going to return after these words from your local stations. Assembly Center in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Dick Martin along with Steve Kelly. 5:19 remained here. Illinois 40, LSU 36. The Illini will be off to Hawaii on Christmas Day. And we look at LSU's schedule down the road. They also will be making a trip over to Honolulu in the Chaminade tournament.
There are a couple of tournaments over keen to get to go over there and play.
Well, they better make good of it, because the NCAA has passed a rule now you can only do it every 4 years, so Illini will not be going. Neither will LSU for 4 years, anyway. Well, this is Jackson outside, works around Bardo, gets the jump shot.
I'll tell you,
folks, he can shoot the basketball.
He's going to be a full Q row here at Baton Rouge before long. I was watching him in the shoot-around earlier in the day, and he has fans in here getting autographs and pictures and everything. He's only a freshman.
Bardo with it, outside the battle. Kendall Gill goes underneath, and Lowell Hamilton gets the shot up and in on a finger roll. Right over the top of the rim with Hamilton, and it's 42-38 Illinois.
Hamilton has 16.
Flips now to Blanton. Long shot. Three-point try is up. Singleton rebounds it away. Fires to Sims. His shot's in.
Battle streaking down court. Puts it up off the glass. I don't know how he got the angle on that, but he did.
It comes into Tracy. Talk about high-scoring basketball. We're going to have it for you tonight, folks. We still have 4 minutes to go in the half. Jackson over the line. Boy, what a move. It's blocked by Gill. Yeah. Stolen away by Hamilton.
Look up, look up. There's Battle. Slam. Battle led about three Illini down there, and Hamilton was coming down on the dribble with the basketball. He finally saw him down there and got it to Kane.
Tracy with it. Fires underneath to Blanton. And a foul on Irvin Small. Blanton will go to the line with two.
A bad foul. Small was beaten by Blanton that time and appeared to have the easy layup. And Irvin made sure that he did not get the shot off, and Blanton will go to the line to shoot a couple.
Coming in for LSU is Moten, and Marcus Liberty coming back in for Illinois, replacing Small. And at halftime, great interview with Lou Lea, talking, I'm sure, about the All-American Bowl that's coming up. We'll be talking about the highlights and the stats of that first half. And boy, we've had a heck of an offensive showing thus far with 3:38 to go. 86 points, now 87 points scored in the game. Illinois leading by five.
Ricky Blanton averaging 26 points a game. That was too strong.
Boy, there's a good rebound by Gill. Missed Liberty, who had gotten in behind. Smith with it. Gill, three-point shot.
Kendall Gill. Gill hitting 56% from three-point range. He was 10 out of 18 before that shot.
Here's Jackson over the line. Gets it to Blanton. Now Sims lets it go. Rebound by Smith.
Battles down there. They get it to him. He lays it up and in.
And Illinois breaking it open right here. Blanton with it. To Jackson. You're not going to hurt that. Oh, what a great feed. Singleton shot. What a great feed by Chris Jackson, the freshman.
Well, look at the smart thing. After the basket, after the Illinois basket, you're not waiting around getting that ball in. Not allowing the Illini press to set up. Oh, nice pass by Larry Smith to Kenny Battle.
One-handed slam by Battle.
I think Larry had intention of shooting the ball. The first thing saw Battle break. Illinois leads by 10.
This is Moten. His first bucket of the ball game.
It's starting to look like an NBA game.
Lou upset because there was no effort at all to play any defense on that last breakaway.
Gill for three.
Kendall Gill has turned it on in Baton Rouge.
Illinois leads it by 11 at 56-45. Just under 2 minutes to go here in the first half.
Boy, Jackson has it slapped away by Battle to Smith. To Battle, off charge on Kenny Battle. You could see it developing that way. Good defense by the Tigers.
A good defensive play on both ends of the court. Battle coming down. He indeed leads the shoulder in.
It was Lyle Moten that really did a job.
Moten had got position and he took the charge.
Sims will inbound it for LSU. slaps it away, picked up by Blanton, up to Jackson now.
Got
to
get back. Nice ball movement again.
I tell you, Lou Henson's got to be just furious about the way we're getting back on defense. We are not, I might add. What a scoring ball game we've got. 56-47. Gil Luth for the shot. Tip up no good. Liberty chases it down on the side. Back to Smith. Back to Liberty on the corner.
Wide open jump. Nice pass there, Larry Smith.
Lou Henson is really after it again to play a little defense, no question about it here. Smith
in a hurry now. Larry Smith's got good defensive pressure on him. And Kendall Gill gets caught on the blocking foul. That's too bad because they might have got that 10-second call. They had definite pressure on them.
Even though there's been a lot of fouls, Steve, only for Illinois, Anderson with two and Bardo with two.
Illinois have 58 points on the board. Lou's probably pretty happy about that, but he is not happy about giving up 47 at this point. Illinois with nine fouls, LSU with four, here with just under a minute to go in the first half.
And Jackson now has canned another one. He is 5 for 5 at the line. 15 points in the first half for Chris Jackson. Marcus, let's make that Hamilton was 16. Now they are tied for Illinois. 56 seconds remain in the half. Illinois leading by 9, you see there. Smith to Gill. Under to Hamilton.
Tough shot, nice tip there.
Great rebound by Marcus Liberty. And a foul on Lyle Mouton.
That'll send Marcus to the line where he is Illinois' best foul shooter thus far this season, hitting 85%.
Now Marcus got good position right here, and you'll see him sneaking around. See number 30 coming behind there, and he'll get up and get position. Look at that.
Marcus,
who said you got to get above the rim to get a rebound? He was below the rim at 6'8".
Rebounding his positioning. Liberty hits it.
Marcus Liberty with 8. Illinois, 61-49.
This is the kind of game everybody thought it would be.
And they're going to go for one shot. Dale Brown says hold it for one. Comes to Jackson.
Moving down to 15 seconds now.
Sims now back to Mouton. You'd think they'd want the ball in the hands of Jackson. Blanton goes up for a shot, but what a great effort by him.
Better hurry. That'll be all.
So, the first half comes to an end. Fighting Illini, leading by 10 in a real offensive show here in the Pete Maravich Assembly Center in Baton Rouge. 61-51. Boy, it's been all offense. Not a heck of a lot of defense, Steve Kelly, in the first 20 minutes. And Blanton did a great job, I might add. We said it should be Jackson basketball. Too bad Blanton didn't hear that. Maybe he did hear it because he fired it in and did a great job. Halftime, and we'll be back with all of our interviews, statistics, whatever. And we'll return to Baton Rouge after these words from your local stations. Well, welcome back to the Pete Maravich Assembly Center in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. And it's a warm day here in Baton Rouge. You would think it was the middle of July and not 3 days prior to Christmas.
Now, the action's hot and heavy here on the court with Illinois leading by 10. Back to that battle travel call, what happened was we talked to one of the referees during our break. They determined that Battle took a shot by hitting the ball off the rim, so that meant when he came down, that was indeed a travel. They say he tried to jam it back over his head, hit the rim, so it went as a shot, and thus went as a travel.
Well, the second half will open. As there you see our next broadcast, the Illini Sports Network, the opening game of the Big Ten season. January 7th in Champaign, the Spartans against the Illini.
It's when the real season begins.
Over the line, this is Chris Jackson. Had 16 points in the first half. Over in the corner to Mouton. Outside, Blanton. Mouton, long jumper is up and out. Rebound, Nick Anderson lobs it way down. This is Kendall Gill. Slams it home, and a foul on Jackson.
Good pass that time by Nick Anderson as he looked up, saw Gill streaking down towards the basket. Jackson was on it pretty tight, as you'll see. There's Nick. He looks up, sees Gill streaking towards the other end, gets the pass down. Kendall makes a nice catch on the ball. Then Jackson trails and gets the foul after Gill got the dunk.
Kendall Gill going for the three-point play. That's the first free throw made by Gill tonight. Comes into Chris Jackson. Jackson moving it across the line. Marching Kendall.
Good move by Jackson. He got Gill to leave his feet, and Jackson dropped in about a 10-foot jumper.
Bardo.
Blanton again is on battle.
Gill underneath the Lowell Hamilton.
He laid it in easily.
18 points in the game for Hamilton. Steal by Gill. A foul is going to be on Chris Jackson, and that's two within 30 seconds on Chris Jackson. His only two of the ball game.
Foul is number 35, Chris Jackson.
Out of bounds. The ball will go to Illinois under their own basket.
Illinois leading 66-53. Dale Brown looking on for the LSU Bayou Bengals in the Death Dome.
Boy, battle. Great turnaround, but a Hamilton on the rebound.
Strong.
And he got it.
Strong game by Hamilton.
20 points for Hamilton. Timeout by LSU, and Dale Brown a little bit upset with his Bengal Tigers across the way. And we're going to return to Baton Rouge after these words from your local station. Recent, really important, Ed Manning, the father of Danny Manning, a pro scout. Boy, there's all kinds of NBA scouts here tonight. Watching this ball game. Here's a shot from the side. Good by Lyle Mutai.
I think those pro scouts are entitled to take a look at Kenny Battle. He will certainly be the most prominent senior in the ball game, along with Ricky Blanton. They had Battle on the back door, but didn't see him.
I'll tell you, they're going to go away talking about that young man right there, Kendall Gill, who now has 19. It's his best performance of the year. They lose the ball, but luckily enough, picked up by Singleton outside, Blanton. Boy, Nick Anderson, what a power rebound that was.
Illinois leads by 15 now with a chance to break it open. Battles
to Kenny Battle.
Enough people to keep up with this kind of ball game all the way against a good top five basketball team. They've shown they can score points, averaging 105 a game, but their competition hasn't been like they have tonight.
Blanton on the side. Out front, Sims goes underneath, and a steal by Battle. Gives it off to Hamilton. What a great dish off by Battle. Hamilton with 22. His best offensive performance of the year.
Dale Brown's kind of sitting with his chin in his hand and his elbow on his knee. Not much he can do about this as his team is down now by 19 and 17 minutes left.
Yeah, here's a young man that can play. He's got 20 points.
You saw the other night how quickly a 19-point lead can change. So nobody's going home here, I guarantee you that.
Gill inside against Jackson on the side. Bardo. Foul is going to be on Singleton.
A nice spin move by Steve Bardo as he got the defender off his feet. Bardo smartly went ahead and put the shot up, and he'll shoot two.
Bardo at the line, and he'll be looking for his first points of the ballgame.
Bardo hitting 77% from the line so far this year. Quite an improvement over last year's shooting where everybody struggled from the foul line.
No, we watched them practice this afternoon, Steve, and they have a game where they see who can hit 20 baskets the most, and that young man right there, Steve Bardo, made the most field goals of anyone on the team this afternoon in practice. So he can shoot. Just doesn't shoot enough, I guess. 76-57, Illinois. Jackson, a long one.
He just comes down and goes between his legs a time or two and puts it up. He'll catch you sleeping.
Nick Anderson has it slapped away by Mouton. Mouton was up over the top of his back and they didn't call it, and it's out of bounds to Illinois.
Jackson and Gill got quite a game going on here as they guard each other and try to score on each other. Do a little talking along the way, too. Here's Gill.
Foul on Jackson.
He is third. Neil Brown upset about that call.
Had a magnificent career here. 17 years coaching, 301 wins, 183 losses. Made it to the Final Four twice. Kendall Gill gets two shots for Illinois.
And he's taken eight of his teams to the NCAA tournament.
Kendall only one of four from the foul line tonight, Steve.
He was shooting three out of four on the average before the year, shooting 75%. Again, a little bit out of his range that time, and here come the Illini. Too many passes.
The Lowell Hamilton scraps the ball out of a crowd and puts in the easy one. 79-60. Sims for the jumper.
This is a racehorse basketball game. Hamilton with that last basket reached his career high. He now has 24.
Swept around. There's Kendall Gill with it. I'll tell you, Kendall Gill, folks, he's everywhere where the basketball is.
The way this is going, Gill may come close to his career high, which is 25 last year against North Carolina.
Dale Brown upset, asks for a timeout. We've got 15:35 to go yet. Look at that score, 81-62, and we're going to return after this on the Illini Sports Network. And there you see the drive by Battle and the slam by Hamilton.
Hamilton, as we mentioned, the new career high. He's leading the score in the ball game with 24. Chris Jackson, as expected, leads LSU with 23 at this point. We have 15:35 to go. The Illinois record for most points in a ball game is 126. And I'd say they're got a good shot of breaking that with 81 at this point.
They're on track. Larry Smith is trying to guard Chris Jackson, and he fouls him. That's the first foul on Illinois in the second half. The ball was out of bounds on the side of the court to the Tigers.
The Illini beat Long Island University 126-78 in the NIT back in 82. That stands as the most points scored by an Illini team. The crowd tonight, by the way, 14,192, so a near sellout.
Anderson rebounds the ball away on the air ball, comes up to Bardo.
That is even more impressive, Dick, with the fact the school is out here. Liberty traveled. He took too many steps.
He looked like he wanted to slam it, Steve, and all of a sudden the LSU player stepped right in front of him, and he just took one too many to get for the reverse.
This is the biggest crowd LSU has had so far. The biggest crowd that prior to this was just over 10,000, keeping in mind that the students are not here, but the fans came out tonight to see the fifth-rated Fighting Illini in action.
Chris Jackson moving to the crowd.
Soft touch. That ball bounced around three or four times and looked like it was going to fall, but wouldn't go. But he does have a very nice touch.
How many times has he come down the floor and not even passed the basketball, Steve?
Well, he's the big gunner, and they got to do some big gunning to get back in this one.
They set him up to be the guy to do everything. You can see that immediately.
Notice the Illini slowing the tempo down just a bit, working it around a little bit, trying to run some of the time off. Still 14 and a half. Is Bardo for three.
And he's got it. 84-62 Illinois. Sims with a 20-footer. Rebound Anderson. To Bardo. Three-point by Marcus. Whoa, what a rebound by Nick Anderson.
Over. That's right. LSU's got to come down and put it up every time they get it. Illinois knows that.
Out of bounds to Illinois. It was deflected away by Blanton. Lou Henson up saying, we got to run the offense, guys. This racehorse basketball up and down is not going to work all year long. Rebound, you can see by Anderson. Watch this strength.
One strong rebound by Nick Anderson, which is what he's known for.
They try to go to the alley-oop to Anderson. They went off of the glass. Down court comes Musin. Gives it to Blanton. Comes nice down pass to the right of the lane. He's a player. He's got 14.
Blanton's one of those guys, when you look at him walking the basketball court, he doesn't impress you.
Bardo goes inside for the drive, and Chris Jackson picks up a foul. His fourth. It will count, and Bardo goes to the line and a chance at a three-point play. And Illinois is at 86, 13 minutes and 17 seconds yet to go in the basketball game.
And the defense has been much better. We talked about the Lou talking with them at halftime about the defense. They've come out with the clamps on and taken LSU out of the game. They didn't have to stay in that running again game, but they just couldn't keep up that pace.
A free throw missed by Bardo. And here come the Tigers. That's Jackson.
There he goes again. Air ball that time.
And there's Nick Anderson on the rebound for Illinois. Zafardo into the corner. Smith. And now Lowell Hamilton dishes underneath.
Nice
and
pass.
Nick Anderson got a good feed from Hamilton. Made it his 10th point. And Illinois leading 88-64.
Well, a lot of people, when they see the Illini, they marvel over the fact of how unselfish they are. And they really are. They don't care who gets the points.
There's Anderson again. Foul is going to be charged to Singleton. I'm sure the NBA scouts are just sitting back here oohing and aahing over the strength of Nick Anderson on those rebounds, Steve Kelly. You can really see it when you're this close to the play.
No doubt about it. And Nick is listed at 215. He weighs more like 225.
John McAvick would like to have a tight end out of him, I'm sure.
I'm sure he would.
I think he'd give him a uniform. You suppose he could play down at Birmingham and make it to Hawaii in time? Outside. Smith with it. DeBardo.
Got it again. Steve Bardo.
Three-point shot, his second of the game, and Illinois leads it 91-64.
He's shooting every time down.
Jackson is fouled by Smith.
Andy Kaufman will check in for the Fighting Illini. His first action in a game or two. He did not see action in the Missouri game, but he'll be coming in right now for Larry Smith, and Kendall Gill also will check back in. Bardo will probably come out. No, Nick comes out to take a seat on the Illinois bench as Lou Henson looks on.
You know, you look at this young man right here who's going to be shooting this free throw, Steve Kelly, and I'll tell you, a lot of time, basketball is a team game, and if you let a young man as a freshman get developing all these single effort shots, coming down the floor and not passing the ball and going right to the shot, eventually it's going to start creeping up on you. I don't care if you make every one you throw up there.
Well, Dale Brown told me last night this is a year that he's just trying to get through. He's got only one senior, five sophomores, five freshmen, and three top 48 guys waiting in the wing, so this is definitely a transition year for him, but he also feels he can sneak up and upset some good basketball teams.
Kendall Gill, three-point shot.
Boy, they're hot. Illinois is really shooting the basketball.
94-65. Mouton outside. This is Blanton. They switch off, and it's started now by Battle underneath the Singleton.
Oh, what a
reject
block
by Battle. And I mean, he really slammed it away, and it goes out of bounds to LSU.
Here's another look at it. Battle high up with his left hand right in front of about 40 Illini fans, and they're the only 40 in here, but they got a good look at that one as he sends it up into the stands.
I saw the Illinois flag flying there behind the basket. Here's Mouton going for the jumper, and he's got it. It's going to count.
We'll get a chance for a three-point play. Lyle Mouton, a 6'4 sophomore out of Lafayette, Louisiana.
Andy Kaufman picking up the foul for Illinois, and it's going to be at the line for LSU. Lyle Mouton. Looking at the three-point shooting, this season, Illinois plays, shot 46% from three-point range, and already tonight, it hasn't been this way for a long time, the Illini have notched a total of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 three-pointers. This is Pardo coming down.
94-68 with 11:20 to go in the ballgame.
Kendall Gill with it. Marcus Liberty back to Gill. Way across to Kaufman. Making a move, bouncing it back to Pardo. Under to Liberty. That's slapped away. They lose it on the floor, and it's picked up out in front by Mouton. Well, he pulls up and shoots a long one, missing the rebound try is Singleton. And Battle has got it for Illinois. To Pardo.
Illinois should throw the alley-oop to Battle. He couldn't get it. Ball throw just a little bit behind him. He couldn't hang in the air long enough to bring it in.
10 minutes and 41 seconds to go. 94-68 Illinois. Glancing into the corner. Sims under to the give and go to Singleton, and the foul is going to be called. It's on Kaufman.
That'll be Andy's second quick foul. Nick Anderson up off the bench to check back into the lineup.
And Kurt Hemming comes in for LSU.
Kaufman, the freshman from Jacksonville, heads back to the Illinois bench after playing about a minute, picking up a couple of fouls, and Singleton will be at the line to shoot two.
Singleton, a 75% free throw shooter, stepping up there for the first time tonight. Out of South Natchez, Mississippi, a 6'6 freshman. They've got three young men here in school at LSU now, 7 foot tall. Two are Prop 48 kids, and I'll tell you, look out for the Tigers in a couple of years with Chris Jackson just a freshman.
Some of their fans that we were talking to earlier had them win the next four national championships with those guys.
Anderson to Pardo. Kendall Gill, three-point try. Rebound, Blanton. This is Tracy with it. The big guy, Hemming, loses it out of bounds. And it'll go back over to Illinois.
He felt the presence of Kenny Battle that time as he couldn't get his hands on it and bring it in under control. Lost it out of bounds. Battle was down in his face, playing good defense. Leads it by 24, but there are 10 minutes left, and you know how that three-point shot is.
Pardo has it out the top of the point to Anderson. And now it's to Gill. Alley-oop inside, Nick Anderson, just straight moving right to the basket. He's got 12.
And not much you can do about that. Nick got position inside. They didn't want to foul him. He just laid it up and in.
Jackson.
He's definitely a player. That's his second three-pointer of the evening.
Boy, what a drive by Gill.
There's a good example there of experience versus youth. Jackson came down, hit the three-pointer, but did not pick up his man, Kendall Gill, and Kendall got the easy layup.
Hey, he can't. He's got four fouls. He's down. Here's Blanton firing. Rebound by Battle, and Illinois has control of this one with 9 minutes and 10 seconds to play. They need a bucket to hit the century mark.
We talked earlier this week about the Illini answering some questions about themselves this week. They answered one on Monday night. They're well on their way to doing it again tonight.
Pardo starting to drive, and a foul. Well, let's see. It's either on Chris Jackson, and that is going to be a foul on Chris Jackson. And he's out of the ballgame, I believe.
He is out. That'll be all for him. That's a key call there. We look at Jackson reaching in, but he falls back. I think Mouton also fouled him, but they call a foul on Jackson, and that'll be it. What a great player he is. He gets a standing ovation here at the Pete Maravich Assembly Center.
28 points on the night for Chris Jackson. He's everything they said he was.
He was one of the top five high school players in the country last year, probably the top point guard, along with Latirio Green. And they played only 30 miles apart from each other down in the Gulfport, Mississippi area.
Dale Brown, I'm sure, is telling his referee over there, why would you do that to my best player? So he's going at it. All fouls on Chris Jackson. Came in the second half. So going to the line for Illinois will be Steve Bardot. Toledo with 10 points. All kinds of guys in double figures here tonight. The five that's, well, the exception of Liberty, five players in double figures.
Bardo with 1-1. We got it.
That makes it 99-73. Has reached the century mark with 8 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the game, 100-73. Here comes Tracy over the line. Back out in front. Long one. Mouton. No. Tipped away, and Anderson just out shuffled him. Here's a pass way down. Kenny Battle can't get to it. LSU gets it back.
Nick didn't see him quickly enough.
Blanton down the middle. Good by Lyle Mouton. Here comes Kendall Gill for Illinois.
Illinois hit by 25 with just over 8 minutes left. Anderson in the lane.
Boy, is that strong. Oh, my. Anderson has 14.
I'll tell you, these scouts from the NBA are getting an eyeful tonight.
And they see he's only a junior. Outside, Tracy. Mouton, long one. And there's Anderson again on the boards. Kendall Gill to Marcus Liberty. What a left-handed turnaround shot from inside by Liberty. He has 10.
The Illini are making believers out of the basketball fans in Louisiana tonight. There's no doubt about the fact that this is the fifth-rated team in the country, and they're showing it tonight.
Shot up, and a foul is going to be on Kaufman. Blanton will go to the line with two shots.
That wasn't a very smart foul. As he shot a three-pointer, that would have been a four-point turnaround had he made the shot. Kaufman picks up his third foul. Watch as Marcus Liberty comes down and takes the pass from Kendall Gill. It was a kind of an alley-oop, but Marcus came up and came back down with it. Then put on the spin move, came around with the left hand, and laid it off the glass and in. That's what made Marcus Liberty the number one high school player in the country a couple of years ago.
Ricky Blanton going to the line with two shots for the Tigers. There you see Dale Brown. He's got a new job, mopping up the floor. He and Lou had some great friends, and I'll tell you, Dale Brown has done a job at LSU. Don't discount his ability to put together a basketball team.
With 7 minutes left, or 7.5 minutes left, some of the fans here at the Maravich Assembly Center decide to make their way out. They think they've seen enough, but the others, old basketball fans, will stick around and watch the remaining action with the Illini.
Well, there's 7:36 remaining, and we've got a break in the action from Baton Rouge, and we're going to return after these words from your local stations. I got a remark to make. Well, there's Dale Brown. Hey, Dale, don't be too sad. Santa Claus is going to be here in 3 days, so you can spice up a little bit. 104-77. That's really what he was upset about. Larry Smith into the corner to Liberty. Marcus pulling up for the jumper. Doesn't get it, but a tip by Small, who has come on. Next one taken away by Gert Hennig. Here's Blanton all the way.
Nice drive by Ricky Blanton as he knew where to take that basketball. 104-79 now. This is not the first time LSU's given up 100 points here at home this year. It's the third time.
Boy, look at Nick Anderson. He's got 16.
Here to get back.
Blanton pulling up for the shot and the scrap for the ball out here on the side. Batted away and a foul on Kaufman. And that is four on Andy Kaufman.
He may set the record for the quickest foul out. He's got four fouls in about 2 minutes of playing time.
Chris Jackson had five in the second half alone. Actually, in about 13 minutes, he picked up the four, five fouls. And it's out of bounds underneath the Tiger basket. Comes
Chris Jackson, nothing he can do about it now.
Blanton's three-point shot.
With Jackson on the bench, Dick, Blanton's the only guy they really got to go to, and Coach Henson wants to take a timeout and talk about that particular fact and more.
106 to 82, Illinois. And we're going to return after this on the Illini Sports Network. Well, welcome back to Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Dick Martin along with Steve Kelly. And we've got a 106 to 82 score, Illinois leading. That's Larry Smith with the basketball for the Illini.
Illinois shooting 73% for the game. That's a record pace. If they keep that up, that'll be a new record.
Nick Anderson to Liberty. Out to Smith. Anderson goes for the shot. And a scramble, and Anderson to Tracy.
Anderson and Tracy exchanging a few words. I don't think Tracy wants to mix it up with Nick. But,
no, I don't think so either.
Coach doesn't want Nick to mix it up with anybody. People hanging on each other. And
B.J. Bowman is going to come into the lineup now for Illinois.
I think Nick's going to come out. Sit him down, let him cool off a little bit.
So Smith will toss it in for the Illini.
Better hurry.
Into the corner to Kaufman. Singleton. Alley-oop pass by Kaufman off of the backboard. Scramble for the ball. It comes out front. Liberty has got it for Illinois. Boy, what a nice move by 6'8" Marcus Liberty.
He is smooth, no doubt about that.
Blanton having trouble with the ball. Picked up, and Tracy, three-point shot. Rebound by Kaufman.
Kaufman coast to coast.
LSU. 5:34 left. You just hope no one gets hurt if play gets a little like this. That was a great drive by Kaufman, nonetheless.
Could have been a foul whistled there, probably either way, a charge or a block, and the ball then went out of bounds.
5.5 minutes to play. Singleton, high archer from the side, and an air ball crossed up. Liberty with a rebound.
Down to the 5 minute mark now, 5:15 to go.
DJ has it slapped away. Tracy on a great effort. Pitches it outside, batted around, and Irvin Small has got it, and he is fouled.
Quite a flurry that time. Irvin Small right in the middle of it. He seems to find his way into the middle of the action when he gets into the ball game. And he was picked up the foul, or he was fouled rather, and he'll go to the line.
Small this season has made 16 of 24. There you see Singleton sitting down for LSU, and there's Irvin Small. He had his camera taking pictures all over Baton Rouge today. Small makes that one.
Makes this one, let out hit 110.
Up, no good, and a foul on McDonald.
he was on Simms' back. Simms had ideas of slamming that rebound home, but McDonald climbed up his back before he could get it done.
And at the line, Wayne Simms. Mark Chaplin checking in the lineup, the senior out of Monticello, Indiana. Monticello, Illinois, pardon me on that. Simms will get the bonus.
4 minutes and 11 seconds left. 112 to 84 now, Illinois.
Chaplin into Kaufman. Now back to P.J. Bowman. Comes to Kaufman. Mark Chaplin. Traveling with the ball. He got the pass in from Kaufman. Couldn't get it around. He was going to dish it off into the corner to Irvin Small for the jump shot.
He got a little excited there on the chance of getting the assist here in Baton Rouge and shuffled the feet.
McKenzie with it outside. This is Glanton. Three-point shot by Glanton is missed. Rebound on the side, and McDonald hustles over to get it for the Illini.
I think Glanton's getting a little tired. The last two or three shots have come up short.
Kaufman, three-pointer. Hammock clears it up court to Tracy.
Nice move, but I think it traveled. They didn't call it.
And for the Illini, Mike McDonald getting the foul.
Andy Kaufman making some typical freshman mistakes. He's having trouble shooting the ball. He's had some signs of looking pretty good so far this season. Dale Brown wants to take a timeout.
Well, there's a break in the action from Baton Rouge. The Illini leading by 112-84. And we're going to return after this on the Illini Sports Network. Our next broadcast will be the opening of the Big Ten basketball season at Champaign. Spartans of Michigan State taking on the Fighting Illini. Judd Heathcote, by the way, was down in St. Louis on Monday night to watch the Illini play. He saw himself quite a basketball game.
He might have gone out of there shaking his head, trying to figure out what he can do and what his team can do to stop the Fighting Illini. They've got to come to Champaign to open the Big Ten season against Illinois.
Tracy rattling the rim with a free throw for the Tigers. Him is his fourth point of the night. Rebound on the missed free throw by Simms. Goes outside to Blanton. Shot by Blanton off of the glass. 112-87 Illinois. Over the line, Andy Kaufman. The three-minute mark at Baton Rouge. Inside, Small loses it. Picked up now by P.J. Bowman. Back outside to Kaufman. Three-point shot by Andy. Tip up, no good. Rebound comes up. Court, that's Tracy with it. Throws it behind his back. Intercepted away. And Irvin Small!
Little showtime action for Easy E.
Driving down the baseline, and he is fouled by McDonald.
The Illini bench is just going crazy about Irvin Small's breakaway slam dunk. Dale Brown not too excited about it. He's just looking to get this over with, as is Lou Henson now. But Kenny Battle and Liberty and Bardo and Hammonds and all those guys high-fiving each other when Easy E came out of the break to slam it home.
Yeah, they're anxious to go back to Hawaii, where they're going to be taking off Christmas Day, heading over to Honolulu to... Their first opponent over there will be Tulsa, by the way.
Yeah, for a while, it looked like there could be a record set for points given up by an opponent for Illinois, and the record is 111. That's at the Assembly Hall.
Could be a record against LSU for points given up. Lanton making that one also, and he's having a good night. Andy Kaufman gets it off to Irvin Small, puts it up off of the glass, doesn't get it down, and out of there coming with the basketball is McKenzie for LSU. McKenzie driving to the basket is fouled by Chaplin. So Mark gets his name in the scorebook. Foul, and for LSU, LSU. Singleton checking back into the lineup, replacing Sims. 2:20 to go.
Kyle McKenzie at the line. He's a sophomore, 6'2" from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Is this one rebound batted around and on a reverse McDonald picks up for himself his fourth foul.
This last 2 minutes could take a couple hours.
Illinois off to their ninth win in a row. They'll be 9-0 after tonight.
Rainbow Classic as the odds-on favorite to win that. In a tough bracket, they played Tulsa first and then would have to meet the likely Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech is also on the regular season schedule later on in the season.
Singleton canning both of those free throws. This is Andy Cotton working against Singleton. To P.J. Bowman.
We'll try one
shot.
Got it! And the Illini bench likes that.
117. Driving is planted. Urban Small rebounds. McDonald is all the way down. There you see, there's a shot by McDonald.
That makes it. And the Illini bench is having a great time watching this game.
Batted away, PJ stopped it away from Tracy.
Illinois now within the all-time record. PJ again for three.
Over there, Steve. They are having fun. Illinois has 122.
The record is 126 for an all-time Illinois record.
This is Sunday afternoon at the Y right now. Hold on, Herman.
Jump ball, it'll be LSU's ball.
It's out of bounds to the Tigers with 117 to play.
The thing about this, you know, Coach Henson not trying to run it up. He's got everybody in there that he can put in there. But Bowman's come down and hit a couple of three-pointers. Herman's ball is playing well. PJ, his three-point shooting was really struggling. He was only 18% going into this game.
Lanton driving for the basket. Over the line is Bowman. Oh, what a move by PJ. Gets it back to Herman Small.
Herman laid it in. 124-94 now.
Driving in on top of Bowman, and a foul is going to be on Singleton for charging, I'm sure.
PJ gets up after taking the hit on the deck. He'll have a chance for 1-1 with 29 seconds left. As we mentioned earlier, Illinois scored 126 points against Long Island back in the NIT in 82. They're at 124 right now with 29 seconds left. I didn't think it went in.
P.J. Bowman is going to have a 1-1 for Illinois.
Well, LSU's at 98 now with 29 seconds left.
Bowman making it 125 to 98. One more for P.J. Bowman. This will tie most points scored by an Illinois team.
He rims it.
Into the corner. Long pass up court now to Blanton.
He'll try one while he passes it off.
But a good follow-up by the big guy, Hemming. Well, a foul on LSU, and it's going to be charged to Lyle Mouton. And with 15 seconds to play, Illinois will be offered a technical foul. He slapped the ball away from the man throwing the ball in bounds. Was it a technical foul?
You look at it as Blanton got the come in and put the ball back up on the rebound. Coughlin can't hit the foul shot.
Andy Coughlin, who made 48 in a row this afternoon in practice, stepped up there and missed the tee.
Well, Illinois still has a chance to break that record as they have the ball. 13 seconds left. Bowman stops, 10-footer, got it! That's a new record.
New record for the Illini, 127 points. And the ball game comes to a finish here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. And what a display of offensive play. And there you see Dale Brown and Lou Henson conversing across the way, longtime friends. And I'm sure Dale Brown is saying, Lou, you got a heck of a basketball team. If he doesn't, he's making a miss right there, right?
I tell you, that's not Lou Henson's kind of basketball game, but they'll take it just the same. Sometimes you got to do what you've